back to those conflicts, really conflicts plural, in the Middle East. There's Iraq and there's Gaza and Israel. We have heard dueling accusations about bias, and in recent weeks on this program, we've talked about what has been said by both sides. But what about the bias that comes from what's not said? What about bias by omission? This was raised by Crossfire co-host E Cupp in a recent op-ed. So to start the show this morning, she joins me here, along with James Zogby, the president of the Arab American Institute. Thank you both for being here. Essie, let me start with you first. You say that when this conflict is covered, there's sometimes a giant glaring omission. So what is it?
Yeah, and it's not sometimes. It's often. It's par for the course. In discussing the demands that Hamas has in the negotiations with Israel, most reporters omit the fact that Hamas's stated main priority, its main objective, is the total destruction of Israel and the annihilation of the Jews.
See, I've watched a lot of cable news, but I feel I've heard a lot about that charter and seen that line quoted many times. You don't think it's come through enough?
No, I think it's something that should be said anytime you are discussing what Hamas wants. And most of the time you hear Hamas wants a ceasefire, Hamas wants a Palestinian state, Hamas wants the blockade in Gaza lifted, Hamas wants its tunnels left alone. Anytime it is omitted that Hamas also wants the annihilation of the Jews and the destruction of Israel, that is an omission that has serious consequences. It has consequences in the political realm. It has global consequences. It's framing the story inaccurately. And again, it creates a false sense of moral equivalency.